This is the first video on the topic of states of matter. Within this unit, we are covering gases as well as liquids and solids, which is chapter 8 and 10 of your textbook. Here's a list of all of the topics that we are going to be covering within this chapter. We'll start with gases and gas laws, and then we will move on to liquids and solids. We will begin our study on states of matter, discussing the properties of gases. Below are listed a variety of properties of all gases. Gases all have mass. They are easy to compress. They fill their containers completely. Different gases can move through each other rapidly through a process called diffusion. They exert pressure. Their pressure depends on temperature, and gases have low densities. So I'll put a few examples with each of the different properties of gas. Have mass. The example I have here is a basketball. If you have a deflated basketball and you take its mass, and then you inflate it and you take its mass, it's going to be heavier. Gases are easy to compress. Airbags contain gas, which is definitely a good thing because they are easy to compress in case they need to be used. Gases always fill their containers completely, like a balloon. So if you're blowing up a balloon, it fills completely. Gases move through each other. This is called diffusion. And the example here would be as if you were baking cookies, or maybe making a holiday dinner of some sort. The entire house smells like the cookies or the food that you're cooking. They exert pressure. In an airplane, as you ascend or descend, your ears pop. That's because the gases are changing in pressure. Your pressure depends on temperature. Tire pressure is a great example here. When it is warm out, your tire pressure tends to be a little bit higher than when it is colder. And we say that gases have low density. Helium balloons will float. And the particles of gas are always spread out more than liquids and solids as well. To be able to talk about gases and the laws that are associated with them, we have to be able to convert between pressure units that exist. The definition for pressure is that it is a physical force exerted on or by an object. Oops, sorry about that. So it's a force per unit area. Some common pressure conversions are, or common pressure units are, atmospheres, ATM, millimeters of mercury, which is MMHg, torr, pounds per square inch, pascals, and kilopascals. We're going to use dimensional analysis here and these conversion factors to answer the questions below. These factors will be provided just as they were in previous units when we were converting things via dimensional analysis. So in this example, it says how many millimeters of mercury are in 2.03 atm. So quick review of dimensional analysis. We put our given over 1. And then we diagonally drop. Since atm is on top, atm has to go on the bottom. And I want millimeters of mercury, so it's going to go on top. And then I use my conversion factors, which would be this one right here. 1 atm is 760 mmHg. And then, of course, I will multiply across. My atm unit crosses out. And I round for sig figs to get 1540 mmHg. Okay. Please pause the video and try the provided practice problem. Please check your answer. You should have gotten 72.2 kPa. All of those conversion factors are equal to each other. They are all equalities that can be turned into any fraction needed. So we were able to just compare torr to the kPa. Torr cancels out because of the diagonal drop, and you're going to multiply and divide. Now let's start our discussion of the gas laws. There are quite a few of them. We'll talk about how to not have to memorize all of them in a little while. Boyle's Law was, of course, discovered by Robert Boyle, hence the name. The relationship that is discussed here is the pressure and volume relationship. Pressure goes up as volume goes down. So this is an indirect relationship between variables. The equation for this is P1 V1 equals P2 V2, where P, of course, stands for pressure and V stands for volume. Some examples that I have are a pillow. So when you first go to sleep, the pillow is usually pretty fluffy. And then sometimes when you wake up or as soon as you lay your head down and apply pressure, it deflates, as well as airbags. So you apply a pressure to an airbag and its volume is going to go down. You're going to use this equation if you're given two pressures and one volume, or if you're given one pressure and two volumes. Charles's law was, of course, discovered by a guy with the last name Charles, and this is the volume-temperature relationship. As temperature goes up, volume goes up. So it's a direct relationship instead, so the equation's going to look a little bit different, and it's in respect to the Kelvin scale. So your temperature must be in Kelvin. The equation looks like this, V1 over T1 equals V2 over T2, and then your Kelvin equation is Kelvin equals degrees Celsius plus 273. Okay, we'll do some practice problems in a little bit with all of these laws. So a good example here, I like to say your fingers, which is kind of weird, I know, or a hot air balloon. If you wear rings in the wintertime, if your hands are cold, sometimes your rings might feel looser. And then sometimes if it's hot and you're wearing a ring, the ring might feel tighter. Okay, that's a connection to Charles's law. When to use, very similar to Boyle's law. So if you're given two temperatures and one volume, or if you're given one temperature and two volumes. The next law is the Gay-Lussac law. It is a pressure-temperature relationship. As temperature goes up, pressure goes up, and vice versa. So this is, again, a direct relationship. And again, we're going to need the Kelvin temperature scale. The equation looks just like Charles's law, but with pressure instead. So it's P1 over T1 equals P2 over T2. And again, the Kelvin scale is needed for temperature. The example I have here is tire pressure, which we discussed on a previous slide. You're going to use this law if you have two pressures and one temperature, or if you have one pressure and two temperatures. Let's continue our study of the different gas laws. The next gas law is Avogadro's number, named after Amadeo Avogadro and the mole. Okay. So the relationship here is connected to amount and volume. So the more you have, the greater the volume. N is what's used to represent amount. So as N goes up, volume goes up, and of course, vice versa. N is moles or molecules. Okay. And it is again a direct relationship. The equation looks just like a lot of the other ones. V1 over N1 equals V2 over N2. N has to be moles or molecules because we know we cannot compare things in grams. The example for this one would be blowing up a balloon. As you add more air to it, it gets larger in size. You're going to use this law if you're given two volumes and one amount, or if you're given one volume and two amounts. We can also kind of combine some of these variables. The combined gas law combines pressure, volume, and temperature. Okay. There really isn't a relationship to fill out here on the chart. Okay. Must be in the Kelvin scale, though, of course, just like before. And so the combined law looks like this. P1 V1 over T1 equals P2 V2 over T2. And again, the temperature has to be that Kelvin scale. Okay. I don't really have a good example for that one off the top of my head. But you're going to use this law instead of the other laws if the problem gives you 5 of the 6 variables. Just like all the other ones have to provide you with 3 of the 4 variables. Okay. So we just covered 5 different laws, and it's a lot, and you would have to potentially memorize all of them. But you don't really need to do that, because what we're going to do is we're going to put it all together. So we're going to combine all these laws into one. So it's going to be the combined law with N as well. So our combined overall law that you should probably memorize instead of the individual is P1 V1 over N1 T1 equals P2 V2 over N2 T2. Okay? You're going to use this equation if you have at least 2 of one of the variables. Okay, so you have to have 2 pressures, 2 volumes, 2 temperatures, or 2 amounts. This is the one that I would memorize. And then what you'll do when you use it is if the problem only talks about pressure and volume, you only use that part of the law. Okay, let's do some example problems now. This first one is a Boyle's Law question. Okay, balloon is filled with 25 liters at 1 atm. Pressure changes to 1.5. What is the new volume? So I like to solve these by labeling things first. The first thing I see is a volume. The next thing I see is a pressure. As I keep reading, I see a second pressure. So I know I'm only dealing with pressure and volume. So I'm going to use just this part of the equation. And I plug my numbers in, and then I do algebra. So 1.0 atm times 25 equals 1.5 times V2. Your V2 is, in essence, an x value, and you solve algebraically by multiplying and dividing, and you get 17 liters for your answer. The next one is a Charles's Law question. It asks you for the temperature of a gas if volume changes from 2.5 liters up to 4.1. So this is your first volume. Here is your first temperature. And here is your second volume. You have to convert temperature to Kelvin. And then again, you solve. So 2.5 over our 25 plus 273 equals 4.1 over T2. Now for this equation, I like to cross multiply. So I'll rearrange it. 2.5 T2 equals my 298, that's the temperature, times 4.1. And then I solve algebraically, and you should get 490 Kelvin for your answer. We'll continue this in our next video.